Dr. Ghaffar, friends, I want to thank all of you for a very stimulating and I would say successful seminar. In the course of the day, I think all of us have participated in these deliberations with a sense of concern, genuineness, shared commitment to improving both the quantitative and qualitative aspects of Muslim girls' education. The scale of the problem, friends, is truly enormous. Although there are many reasons to be hopeful, to be optimistic, because in the past 10 or 20 years the community itself has become far more aware and active in promoting education among, you know, education in general, including education for girls. In spite of this, we have a long, long, long way to go. Just one piece of statistic that Professor Jain mentioned in her very eloquent and passionate, candid presentation, that if only 2.5% of Muslim girls reach the level of graduation, that's higher education, which is lowest among religious communities in India, then it is certainly a matter of concern for not just the Muslim community, it's a matter of concern for all Indians. Because education doesn't mean only literacy. Of course, that is important. That is absolutely essential. Education doesn't mean only primary education, satvi tak, dasvi tak, jada se jada, baravi tak, aur uske baad darwaje band. This cannot be the case. You know, all those Indians, irrespective of the religious community they belong to, and irrespective of whether they are men or women, if they are desirous of continuing their education, must be able to do so. There should be absolutely no deprivation and no discrimination. Yet there is discrimination from society as a whole against the Muslim community, and many instances were recounted even by you, Professor Sheikh, and this is shameful. And there is also discrimination from within the community. I'm saying this with a little hesitation, because I'm a non-Muslim, but as an Indian, I'm very concerned when I find that, and it's not that this discrimination, internal discrimination, is there only among Muslims. There is such discrimination that even non-Muslim women face. That also ought to be a matter of concern. But as far as the Muslims are concerned, I believe that it ought to be a very strong commitment and a campaign by the community to remove all the internal obstacles to women's education. This is a responsibility of the community itself, the religious leaders, the intellectuals, the social leaders, the elite, the economic elite. They must come forward and remove all the internal obstacles while at the same time demanding an end to discrimination from the rest of society and an end to any lack of support from government. You know, as was very very persuasively stated by Dr. Ghaffar, our constitution, and it was stated by many others, that we have one of the best constitutions in the world, completely non-discriminatory. It provides equal rights to one and all, irrespective of caste, community, gender. And it really comes as education for people like us who are non-Muslims, that Islam itself puts such high premium on education, on knowledge. I mean, there is a saying by Prophet Muhammad, I mean, I've just read about it, that if you have to gain knowledge, even if it means you have to go to China, go and gain knowledge. I mean, there is an excerpt from the Holy Quran there, Islam on education. So there is nothing that stops from within Islam, and there is nothing that stops from within our constitution. This being the case, there should be absolutely no obstacles to Muslims moving forward in education and attaining their full potential. And when they attain their full potential, the community will attain the full potential. And when the community attains the full potential, India will attain the full potential. You know, I was very impressed by what Professor Jain said, that we have to take into account the specific circumstances in which the community lives, especially the large poor section of the community lives, and our policies and programs and all of the initiatives should be designed taking into consideration these circumstances. And as she said, it should be, you know, ghetto oriented, because the fact of the matter is that the community, unfortunately, is living in ghetto like conditions. Now, this being the case, it is the responsibility of the government, it is the responsibility of the community, both the Muslim community and the non-Muslim community, to reach out to the places where they live. Their homes must become classrooms, as is indeed the case. Jo Firoz Bhai ne prove kar dikhaya hai. I mean, uncle's classes, where do the classes take place? The classes take place in their 8x8 homes. Aur jo Firoz Bhai jaise log jo hain, aise sansthaon ko puri tarah se madad dena, ye sarkar ki zimmedari hai aur ye pure samaj ki zimmedari hai. To hamare rules aur procedures, jo sarkar ki baatein, you know, they have their own limitation, they have a way of functioning that is completely understandable. But it is the responsibility of the political executive to understand how we reach education to different communities, taking into account their specific circumstances. Ye bahut zaruri hai. Second, ये बात भी बहुत जोर से आई इस सेमिनार में कि, और मैं आपसे सहमत हूँ कि एजुकेशन, अनफॉर्चुनेटली ओवर द लास्ट फ्यू सेंचुरीज इन इंडिया, इट हैज बिकम मोर एंड मोर रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम रिलीजन. आई मीन नॉट जस्ट फ्रॉम इस्लाम बट इवन फ्रॉम अदर रिलीजन्स. सो मच सो दैट अ सो कॉल्ड एजुकेटेड पर्सन is supposed to think that religious education is not education. Aur main kabhi kabhi main hindu hu, और आई एडमायर मुस्लिम्स बिकॉज यू टेक सच कीन इंटरेस्ट इन इम्पार्टिंग रिलीजियस एजुकेशन टू योर चिल्ड्रन विच इज नॉट द केस अमंग हिंदूज. You know, our educated Hindus today know very little about our own history, our own religious principles, our moral moorings. इसलिए आपने जो कहा कि moral education, our education must go, moral education and what we call secular education must go together. And when we say this, obviously, different communities have different traditions, and these traditions must be respected. You know, Muslim community and within the Muslim community, there are different traditions. These traditions should be respected. Non-Muslim communities, they have their traditions. They also must be respected. At the same time, one point that did not really come in the seminar, but I would like to articulate that, while remaining true to our own different traditions, we should also be learning more and more about each other. क्योंकि ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि मुस्लिम बच्चे मुस्लिम लड़के लड़कियां केवल इस्लाम के बारे में ही वो पढ़े. वो तो बहुत जरूरी है, वो तो नींव है, that's the foundation. At the same time, we are a diverse society, we are a pluralistic society. So as we grow, we are bound to interact with each other in 100 different ways. And when we interact with each other, we should not have prejudices about each other. So Hinduism aisa hai, Christianity aisi hai, Islam aisa hai. So sahi Islam kya hai, sahi Hinduism kya hai, sahi Christianity kya hai. Iske baare mein kam se kam ek minimum jankari, minimum understanding. ये हमारे एजुकेशन से, हमारे पूरे सोसाइटी के लिविंग में से ये आनी चाहिए. विच इज एब्सोल्युटली एसेंशियल फॉर कम्युनल हार्मनी, फॉर सोशल हार्मनी, फॉर नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन. तो इसलिए मैं दो बातें हैं, जब आपने कहा कि इस सेमिनार से मैंने जो सीखा कि व्हाट इज द वन बिग रीजन व्हाई Muslim families do not send their girls for education above a certain level. One big reason is that they feel that their specific concerns are not taken care of. If someone wants to come in a particular dress, there should be no discrimination. There should be no prohibition. ये हम समझ सकते हैं. Or, you know, any concern that Muslims have, genuine concern, these must be respected. And if you take care of these concerns, obviously more Muslims will send their girls to schools, to colleges. And if more girls get educated, it is good for the families, good for the community, good for the country. This is understandable. At the same time, since we are one nation, we are a multi-religious nation, multi-religious, multi-community nations. We also should know about each other and learn to respect each other. And the soul of our nation is that we all are highly religious people. Religious in the true sense of the term. And therefore, I agree with you that ye jo hum बिल्कुल आप अल्लाह कहिए, भगवान कहिए, जो भी परमात्मा कहिए, इसको हमने एजुकेशन से निकाल दिया है. इससे ना उस इंसान का भला है, ना फैमिली का भला है, ना देश का भला है. बट दिस हैज टू बी डन इन अ वेरी केयरफुल मैनर. मित्रों, जस्ट अ फ्यू मोर पॉइंट्स. I think that Muslim institutions should become far more proactive and far more dynamic. मेरे पास Education World is a fairly reputed journal devoted to education. This is their latest issue, September 2014, and India School Rankings 2014. The best schools across the country. Now, I was seeing this, and I was sad to see that there are not many Muslim institutions that rank among the best schools, the best colleges. This must change. You know, I'm very happy to see several representatives of Anjuman-e-Islam. Aaj Dr. Zahir Qazi sahab ko humne bulaya tha, wo aa nahi sake. लेकिन मैं डॉक्टर ज़हीर काजी साहब से अक्सर बात करता रहता हूँ. यू नो, इन अ सिटी लाइक मुंबई, यू नो, इनफैक्ट अंजुमन ए इस्लाम इज ओल्डर देन अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी. सो आई सेड, व्हाई डजंट अंजुमन ए इस्लाम बिकम अ यूनिवर्सिटी? यानी आप पूरे मुंबई में एक भी मुस्लिम एजुकेशन द्वारा शुरू की गई एक भी मेडिकल कॉलेज नहीं है. एक भी कोई बड़ा मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन नहीं है. सो आई एम सेइंग दैट द मुस्लिम इंस्टीट्यूशंस मस्ट कम फॉरवर्ड एंड दे मस्ट थिंक बिग, दे मस्ट बिकम एम्बिशियस. मुझे बहुत अफसोस होता है कि मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी में एम्बिशन कम है. बुरा मत मानिएगा, योर कम्युनिटी मस्ट बिकम एम्बिशियस, मस्ट सेट अप ग्रेट इंस्टीट्यूशंस एज सम ऑफ योर यू नो पीपल हैव एक्चुअली डन. यू नो, वी इंडिया इज द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड. You should set up institutions that become globally renowned. Friends, you know, we recently at the Observer Research Foundation, we have recently done one report on science education in Indian colleges. How to reform science education, urgent reforms to meet the challenges of a knowledge society. Aur uske baad we invited Bharat Ratna Dr. C.N.R. Rao, who, as you know, he won the Bharat Ratna this year, very eminent scientist, to release this report. After that, we have prepared a manifesto, a draft manifesto, which we are circulating to all the colleges, universities around the country to create a debate on the kind of reforms that are needed in science education. And we want to submit this manifesto to the Honorable Prime Minister and urge the government to implement these reforms. मेरा कहने का मतलब ये है कि in all these debates and in all these initiatives, I would like to see more and more Muslim educationists to come forward and participate, Muslim scientists to come forward and participate and give direction to the nation. क्योंकि हमारे सामने जो चुनौतियां हैं, हमारे सामने जो समस्याएं हैं, वो बहुत बड़ी हैं. और इन समस्याओं को हल करने के लिए योर कम्युनिटी, विच इज सच अ लार्ज कम्युनिटी, द लीडर्स ऑफ योर कम्युनिटी, यू मस्ट टेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. समस्याएं हैं, देर आर प्रॉब्लम्स, देर इज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. आई एग्री विथ यू एंटायरली, देर इज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. एंड if law is required, even law is necessary for fighting discrimination. But I have one point, Professor Jain, that discrimination in society cannot be fought by law alone. इसके लिए societal action की बहुत जरूरी है, क्योंकि देखिए आज हमारे unfortunately हमारे समाज में ये जो हिंदू मुस्लिम डिवाइड है, ये जो prejudices हैं, ये इतनी गहरे हो गए हैं कि लॉ होने के बाद भी ये अपने आप जाएगा नहीं। तो इसलिए हमारे समाज में हम सब एक हैं, हम सब भारतीय हैं, हम सब इंसान हैं, इस दृष्टि से सबको साथ। अब हमारे प्रधानमंत्री अमेरिका जाते हैं और ओबामा के साथ बात करके क्या नया स्लोगन क्या है, साथ चले, नहीं नहीं वो तो है, लेकिन देयर इज द न्यू स्लोगन विद अमेरिका इज चले साथ साथ। अच्छी बात है, लेकिन घर के अंदर भी चले साथ साथ होना चाहिए ना। हाँ हाँ, घर के अंदर भी चले साथ साथ होना चाहिए। और जब गुजरात के कौन आप यहाँ आए थे और आप यहाँ आई थी और 2002 में जो कुछ हुआ वो सुनकर, हाँ यू नो इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ शेम फॉर अस, दिस मस्ट नेवर हैपन अगेन, दिस मस्ट नेवर हैपन अगेन, वी मस्ट क्रिएट अ सोसाइटी विदाउट रायट्स, विदाउट एनी काइंड ऑफ वायलेंस, दैट इज ट्रू एजुकेशन। तो इसलिए मेरा कहना इतना ही है मित्रों, दैट वी हैड अ गुड सेमिनार टुडे। और सुबह आपने कहा कि सेमिनार्स होती हैं, बातें होती हैं और उसके बाद, नो, ये सेमिनार जो हमने आयोजित किया है इसका पर्पज़ ये है कि हम ना केवल बात करके बैक टू स्क्वायर वन, ऐसा न होना है। वी हैव कम हियर टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम ईच अदर, टू लर्न फ्रॉम ईच अदर एंड कलेक्टिवली टेक वन स्टेप फॉरवर्ड और अ फ्यू स्टेप्स फॉरवर्ड टू चेंज द सिचुएशन। और इसलिए इस सेमिनार के बाद अपर्णा, डॉक्टर गफ्फार और हम सब मिलकर एक रिपोर्ट बनाएंगे एंड वी विल ट्राई टू रीच दिस रिपोर्ट टू द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ऑनरेबल HRD मिनिस्टर, ऑनरेबल न्यू चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, एंड वी वुड लाइक यू नो ऑल सच वॉइसेस टू कम टुगेदर। Dr. Gaffar, you know, as I mentioned earlier, you know, she's been going around the country holding such seminars, you know, visiting your institutions. She'll even go to that, what village is it? You know, some village, a 30-acre village that one of you, near Pune. Huh? Yeah, you know, for orphan girls, you know, what a godly work it is. So she goes and visits all such institutions. She knows who is doing what. So this is how government should work. We need more and more such government officers who have sensitivity, who have commitment, who have heart. तो इस सेमिनार के बाद हम रिपोर्ट बनाएंगे और रिपोर्ट को हम पब्लिसिटी देंगे, उस पर आवाज उठाएंगे और आप सबके सहयोग से, कोऑपरेशन से हम इस बात को और आगे ले जाना चाहते हैं। हमारी एक बहन ने थर्ड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन की बात की, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन अगेंस्ट यू नो चैलेंज फिजिकली और मेंटली चैलेंज चिल्ड्रन। हम उसमें भी ऑब्जर्व रिसर्च फाउंडेशन थोड़ा काम कर रही है। वी हैव जस्ट डन अ वेरी गुड रिपोर्ट ऑन how to improve mental health care among children through education and also through a certain medical intervention. To ye jo sab baatein hain, if we come together, if we work together, we can be more effective. So at least I am very satisfied, friends, that we've had a satisfying and a fulfilling seminar, and I want to thank you all for this, but I especially want to thank Dr. Shabistan Ghaffar for guiding this seminar. And I can't thank my colleague because she's my colleague, but Aparna, all of you should give her a big hand. You know, Aparna and my other colleague Sumedh, they have written this book which is now with you. Please read it. It shows the deep appreciation that all of us at the Observer Research Foundation have for Firoz Bhai's work. And the same has been shown by what our other brother, Mazhar Kamran, has done, his film. You know, his film on Uncle's classes. I told him that my wish and my dream is to persuade Rashtrapati ji to show it at Rashtrapati Bhavan for members of parliament and for other senior officers. Hum chahenge ki ye television par aa jaye, lekin hum aapse ek vinanti karte hain ki aap sabke paas iski copy hai. आप कृपया अपने अपने स्कूलों में, अपने एनजीओ में और जहां जहां भी संभव है, आप इसका स्क्रीनिंग कराइए. बिकॉज व्हेन आई वॉच्ड इट, आई क्राइड थ्रू आउट द फिल्म. देर इज अ क्वेश्चन दैट फिरोज भाई आस्क इन दैट, क्या यू नो, शुड वी कॉल दिस होम? The places where they live, can it be called a home? Is this the India we want to build? No. We will change this India. We will change this India through education. Thank you very much.